Okay, so my wife and I are working on this Westphalia. We're trying to replace the pop-up top, the canvas here. So as you can see, they did an awesome job of duct taping it and everything. So yeah, so what we gotta do is there's like a strip here with aluminum and a bunch of star-headed screwdrivers or screws that are holding it into place. So we're just trying to take this off, and you know, it says about 4 to 8 hours in order to get this out. So I don't think it'll take us this long, but we got this flooring down, and we just have to glue it, and we just have to let it sit and settle, because see how it's all ripply still? Well, it'll settle down. It just it's been pried up for the week, so it just has to be slid underneath. Comes with instructions, we're just following those. And basically we've loosened each one of these a couple turns, and then I got a power tool, and we'll just take each one out and we'll collect them in a bucket here. So some of them have come up easy, others have been bad, but it's really bad when they get corroded.
I broke one in half.
You broke one in half? Oh no. Well, we got lots of extras. But yeah, so there's these strips here, loom strips that hold it right down and hold it right tight. So one of these canvases are big money. They're about, they range from like 400 to 800. And anyways, we got this one. Hopefully it's the right one. We selected the right year and everything, but they make a couple versions. They make a Canadian and a European version. So hopefully it fits the way it's supposed to. So yeah, I'll use my trusty DeWalt, and we'll get the rest of these screws out. Yeah, so you can see like the zipper quit working on this one, so anyways, I think the mice have been into it too.
Is this like a burn hole maybe?
Hard to say. I don't think
it's a weird spot.
Child would be fire. Smoking.
Yeah, never know. It was the 70s.
It is a hippie van. Could be cannabis. So I gotta get this over to the Wilsons to get safety. I got the list. I got the pump. I got everything I need to do. It's just a matter of doing the work.
Look at the piece of wood itself is
rotten. We just flipped this off. It took three people to get it off. I think he loves to wind the windows up and down in this thing. It's hilarious. So yeah, we got a convertible now. Cool. You can see the original orange paint up here is pretty. But basically, we've got to undo all this stuff and put the new canvas in its place. And
this is not a pretty fix. See this piece here? This piece here is rotty.
Water's got it in there or something.
From a rotten piece of wood.
How do you take that piece of wood out?
Very carefully.
It's probably glued in or something?
This guy's wet, spongy wet.
Yeah.
Andrew, we're not taking this camping on Wednesday.
You know what I'd be tempted to do is cut it here and here, take that rotty piece out, and then put a new piece in that's the same size, and then put a piece from here to here to hold it, right?
Okay, so I cut out that rotten part that was right there. What had happened is water had got in there and it just kind of rotted out that hunk of wood. So I cut out the bad very carefully. I put a metal slip underneath and a metal slip on the other side. And then I just used the reciprocating saw blade really carefully and then got it so far. And then I just used a screwdriver to snap out the rest. And I'm going to make up another one of these, and I got to follow the contour of that. And I'll put that there, and this block was missing altogether, so I'll just kind of copy the same as the other side there. And then once that's done, then I gotta find a staple gun. I know I have one, but it's just a matter of finding it. With that tool acquirement, the shed or shop clean out kind of thing, I think I got one, but I don't know where it is, so I'll have to do some digging, see what I can come up with. But what I plan on doing is just kind of patching this into here and then making a couple of those, and then we'll be good to go. Got the canvas there and it appears to be the same, so hopefully everything will get done today. Well, there we go, we got it all in place, and my little patch job right there seemed to work out okay. So now it's just a matter of hooking it all up. These things, we got replacement one of these, but they're a different setup. This uses this setup where you have, you know, that thing goes in there and that goes like there. And anyways, this one actually uses a different style. The old ones, had like a clip style, like right here. It just clipped on there, so I'll have to take those out and then put in the new style. But anyways, yeah, this is the tough part to get this part in. You can see this is the original color right here, and then the top is all dirty right there. So yeah, I'm gonna be cleaning that first. And you can see a little bit of mouse poop that was in the track there and over there. So yeah, I'm just gonna give this a quick clean off, and then we'll be putting this on. Alright, with much heaving and hoeing, we got this camper top into place. A couple of the holes are just, the one up there is not really wanting to cooperate. These two worked. This one, we have to drill a hole in the corner there to be able to go through. But anyways, you know, if you notice these stars are on the ceiling here, the glow-in-the-dark stars, I remember having those when I was a little child. And so yeah, anyways, we're just hooking this up, and then take a look at the bucket of screws. All these, there's a, I don't know, I'd say about maybe 50 of those screws in there. Anyways, and they go in all the strips, the aluminum strips, all down there, so we can quickly know what one goes where. And then it's just a matter of tightening everything down. Very time consuming. But we'll get it.